Tonight, she's naming names and detailing alleged harassment and discrimination in the Iowa Senate.
It's all laid out in an Iowa civil rights complaint, and our Emily Price has the story this new at 10. Emily?
Kevin and Stacey, Kirsten Anderson filed this five-page complaint with the Iowa Civil Rights Commission last week. For the first time, we're learning who she is accusing and what allegedly went down at the state capitol.
Since 2008, she helped control the message for Republicans in the Iowa Senate. Today, former communications director Kirsten Anderson is giving great detail to what things were allegedly like behind closed doors, working for Senate Minority Leader Bill Dix and members of the Republican staff. Senator Dix is at the top of the list of people she complains about. And then there's his assistant, Ed Failer Jr., senior analyst Jim Friedrich, and staff director Eric Johansson. Anderson calls it, quote, a male-dominated workplace that allowed sexism and frat house chatter to flourish.
No mother, sister, or daughter should have to hear inappropriate jokes or hear about other women's body parts.
That was Anderson on May 20th, 3 days after she got fired. This complaint released today says one day as she was leaving for lunch with her husband, a male staffer asked if she was going to have a little tickle pickle. She says one staffer had her come look at a picture of a naked woman on his computer and repeatedly made derogatory remarks about women, including female lawmakers. The report says Senator Dix called a meeting on January 10th to address the complaints and said then that he had zero tolerance for this kind of behavior. But Anderson says that didn't put an end to the comments. She says she got fired in May after continuing to speak up about the improper behavior under the Golden Dome.
Hopefully, those inappropriate comments about body parts and the ridicule and the inappropriate jokes will not be an issue in the future.
I reached out to all four men named in this complaint. Two of them got back to me, Ed Failer and Eric Johansson. They say on the advice of the Attorney General's office, they are not able to talk at this time.
But Senator Dix had earlier said, right, that Anderson had a poor job performance?
That's right. They say that is why she was fired. But Anderson points out that she was given a pay raise as recently as this January. Her lawyer tonight told me that the civil rights complaints come just before lawsuits, so they have not yet decided if they're going to file one.
All right. Thanks, Emily.